In today's tutorial, you'll learn how to add photo textures and how to make all the way from the pencil sketch to finished illustration. You'll understand how to trace your sketch, how to apply colors from your own photos to your illustrations, how to export Adobe Illustrator file to Photoshop with all layers, and how to apply photo textures to your own illustrations. You're watching TNT tutorials, let's move on! Here you can see all stages from a rough idea to clean sketch. First, we draw a few different frames to see which proportions will work best for us. At this stage, we also draw rough sketches of the composition. It is very important to avoid any details. We need to get a very simple and clear picture, where the main object will be clearly highlighted. Next, you see a few examples of how the original idea evolves. We still avoid details and try to concentrate on the main objects, the character and the huge mushroom. The environment that surrounds them should be secondary and simply supplement our picture. These sketches can look dirty. You can forget about eraser, all you need is to find out what you'll draw exactly and how. The last stage is a clean sketch. Its main difference from the previous stage is that now we first draw without any pressure on a pencil and use an eraser. Follow the light contours with pressure on a pencil only when you are confident in drawing. This will allow you to use the eraser less often. Now that the sketch is ready, we can take a picture of it and continue in Illustrator. By the way, you can download sketch, texture photos and colors on my Patreon. Place sketch. Apply multiply blending mode. Decrease opacity. And lock sketch layer. Create a new layer and bring it down. This is how you can see sketch and vector at the same time. Use grayscale to trace all shapes. This will allow you not to think about colors and simply pick different gray tones for different objects on a fly. Use the pen tool, the shape builder tool and the blob brush. Don't create too many anchor points with the pen tool. It's very easy to change shapes when you have a few points only or at least as less as it possible. Drag handles a bit and hold Alt or Option key to make sharp corners. To use the shape builder tool, select needed shapes, press Shift plus M, hold Alt or Option key, and drag or click on a needed area to delete it. Blob brush is a bit more tricky and you need a tablet if you want to use it. I show how to adjust the blob brush in this tutorial, so check it out if you want to trace like you can see here. Blob brush turns strokes to objects automatically, so to fill shapes, I simply select a random inner anchor point and press Ctrl or Command plus X twice. You can trace everything with the pen tool if you don't have a tablet. There's no problems with that. This is how your complicated illustrations should look like. Just take your time, give yourself a break and trace each shape one by one. This is a routine, which you should simply pass and move on. I usually listen to podcasts or music while tracing, so I enjoy this process. You can use any picture or a photo to color your illustrations. I show a few must-know coloring tips in this tutorial, and today I'll share another great way to do that. I want to use colors from this photo, but they're not clean and bright enough. Open your photo in Photoshop and click on this little icon below in the Layers panel. Choose Selective Color. And in Selective Color menu, switch between colors and play with all that sliders. As you can see, you can change colors completely. Let me show you how I adjusted sliders for this picture. After you'll finish, go to File, Export, Save for Web, choose any format that you want, and click on Save. Let's return to Illustrator and place edited photo here. Select needed shapes and use the eyedropper tool to pick colors from photo. If you feel that you want to play with colors more, open colors panel and adjust them. I always switch between HSB and RGB modes. This allows to change colors extremely fast and easy. Now we are ready to export illustration to Photoshop and apply photo textures. There are a few crucial moments that you should pay attention to if you want to create illustrations like this. I will explain why it's better to adjust textures in Photoshop, but first things first, take a look at all these layers. If you want a successful export from Illustrator to Photoshop and have the same layers there, you should put each object into separate layer. It takes time to rename each layer, so prepare to spend some time doing this. Let's click on File, Export, Export As, in File Type select PSD, copy settings from this setup, and click OK. File will be exported and we can already launch Photoshop. Let's open exported file in Photoshop and take a look at layers. Here they are, named, separated, and ready to use. Select needed object first when you want to apply texture to it. I'll select this one. Then open photo textures, which you can find anywhere in the internet or download on my Patreon, and drag them to your artboard. Let's apply clipping mask by holding Alt or Option key and click between these two layers. Press Ctrl or Command plus T to change proportions and rotate texture, and press Enter after that. Click here and highlight blending modes to see which one will work the best for you. Next that you want to do is decrease fill and opacity. To make texture lighter, press Ctrl or Command plus M to use curves and adjust lightness like this. You should not use one texture only. Take a look at how I apply a few textures to work together. Notice how I transform textures, change blending modes and opacity. Sometimes original color might be lost behind the textures. This is not a problem since you know that you can use curves. Apply them to your textures to make textures more contrast or faded. You can also use levels for that. Press Ctrl or Command plus L to use them. You can press Ctrl or Command plus I and invert textures like this. I always invert textures and check how they will look inverted, because picture can be absolutely different. There's no such option as curves or levels in Adobe Illustrator, but I have a few reasons more why it's better to apply photo textures in Photoshop. You can completely erase some areas with the eraser, or change eraser density and simply make texture a bit more transparent. You can also click on this icon below in the layers panel to create a mask. Pick black color. With masking we are not erasing, but simply hiding areas, so we can always reveal them. It also feels much more comfortable to finish illustration in Photoshop. You can use custom brushes to quickly add noise or details, and your computer will handle this much easier comparing to the same actions in Illustrator. Here is a few close-ups for those who want to illustrate in this style. Don't forget to press thumbs up if you learned something new from this tutorial, and also subscribe so you don't miss more useful tutorials like this. Thank you all for watching and see you in the next video!